I'm going to take you on a little tour of the AI-powered features that we're most excited about. So we know that Newsela is mostly known for our vetted and curated library of nearly 20,000 resources. And one of the biggest requests that we get, and Jason was calling this out, are for more activities, supports, to make it even easier to incorporate these into resources, these resources into like a lesson or a unit. So over the past year, we've been developing a range of AI-powered teacher supports within Newsela, and we're really excited to bring them all under the umbrella of Luna. We want to make it easier to find those supports, as well as make it really clear and transparent where Luna is working, even if it's just behind the scenes. So to set the stage, one of the most popular use cases for Newsela is building background knowledge. And as we know from the reading rope, it's a critical component of language comprehension. This provides a foundation for understanding new information and making connections to existing knowledge. So I'm going to go ahead and walk through some AI-powered resources that are available on a text that is part of a novel study for The Tempest by Shakespeare. So as you can see in this novel study, we have a lot of resources here. We have videos, we have articles, we have primary sources. But in the spirit of background knowledge, let's go ahead and select this specific article about Shakespeare's global influence, and let's see what kind of AI-powered resources are available from Luna. So I'm gonna go ahead and open this. Awesome, so we've selected the article, and as you scroll down, one of the first things that you're gonna see is this apply to your lesson box. We have four tabs here. The first one is main idea, and this was actually added based off of teacher feedback to ensure that the text, like the overall text, meets their instructional needs, especially at a glance. Next, we have key terms. These are some tier three vocabulary words that are great for pre-teaching, challenging vocabulary. We also have a before reading activity. So these are some questions that are great for activating interest and continuing to build background knowledge. Then, of course, we have discussion questions. So this is great to confirm comprehension after reading, but also can help determine any next steps that might be needed as you're teaching. All right, so moving on from the apply to your lesson box, as you go down into the text, you're gonna see some of these terms, like for example, some of these that we saw in the key terms box. And so I'm gonna click on one, so translated. We can see here the term as well as the definition. So students can see this, they can access the term and they can see the definition, but they can also listen to it read aloud to them. This is actually a really commonly requested scaffold from striving readers. So really excited to have this available to them from Luna. As we go on, again, going through the text on this given article, we're gonna see the check for understanding question. So these are some great Luna-powered questions that can help the student check to make sure they're comprehending everything as they're going through it, before they actually proceed to the rest of the article. So as we can see, we're actually in like a teacher view, but if I turn on the student view, we can see what this looks like. So the student, they're gonna come in, they're gonna be reading the article, they're gonna encounter the check for understanding question, and everything beyond it is gonna be blurred out, it's gonna be inaccessible. The way that they reveal that is they just select the answer, hit submit, and from there, the rest of the article is gonna be available to them. Until they hit the next check for understanding question. But yeah, so really excited about these tools that are gonna be available. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave the student view to get back into the teacher view. And I wanna take some time to actually go over to the right side of the screen over here, the assignment builder. Scrolling down, you can see we have a lot of different options here. These are a bunch of different scaffolds and tools that are available. And one really popular scaffold that we've used introduced is guided highlighting. So I'm going to go ahead and click this to activate it. I'm going to hit view, and you can see that we have some AI powered prompts. So these guys right here, these AI prompts can be used to help students focus on what to annotate, what to look for as they're reading the article. One cool thing about guided highlighting is that as the students are actually looking in the text to highlight that text, to respond to the prompt, Luna can actually score this for you. So it'll actually save you some time as well. All right, so getting back to the assignment builder, One other thing that we're really excited about are our AI-powered graphic organizers. So it's down here. I know my face is covering some of that, sorry. But I'm gonna click this and you can see we have a range of different graphic organizers available to you. These are already gonna be pre-populated by Luna to help get you started. But let's choose one of these, like maybe the Frayer model. So especially if you're thinking about building some more word knowledge, you can see that we have a term already inserted here in the center. We have the definition already populated, and we have these other fields that are actually editable. So if you want to add more text, you totally can. But once you have this graphic organizer set, you're happy with it, you can always click this button right here to download it as a PDF. So you can print it or otherwise distribute it to your students. So I do want to say that we're really excited about these graphic organizers. The feedback from teachers about these has honestly been incredible. So we're really excited for everyone to have access to these for back to school. We are looking to add more graphic organizers, excuse me, in the fall. And we're going to continue to add more features and functionality to Luna as we proceed. So speaking of feedback, one other thing that I want to highlight is in paragraph translations. This was a super highly requested feature. So it's right here. If you click this button, you're going to go down into the text and you're going to see each of these paragraphs has this button here. You can go ahead and click that and you can see the translation appear. So you'll be able to select one from over 40 different languages that we have available. And to be clear, a lot of time and research went into this to ensure that we had the most accurate and best translations possible. So we're really proud of that. And I will also call out that this kind of feature, I think someone actually asked something about this in the Q&A. So I think this can also give you some context there. translations, this is gonna be really helpful for those districts that are adopting a translanguaging approach. So this is where the school values students bringing all the languages they speak to contribute to their learning. So that the native language isn't a barrier to them building that background knowledge. All right, so we've run through a ton of stuff really quickly. One more thing I just wanna highlight is control. So like we saw over here in the assignment builder over here on the right side, we have these checkboxes. And you can always uncheck them to give access or grant access. But as you're looking to actually assign this type of content to your students, and you go into the assignment flow, you can come down here and you can also see additional checkboxes to either enable or disable these AI features. Ultimately, we want to put the control back in your hands as a teacher so you can always make that decision on which AI-powered scaffolds are going to be available to your students as a part of the assignment that you're giving them. Okay, so all that being said, I do have one more thing, and this is a sneak peek of a feature that is being released this Thursday. So as I mentioned before, Newsela has a really great catalog of like 20,000 high quality vetted articles that are already leveled for you. But like, we get it. You're surfing the open web, you find something really cool, and you're thinking, I would love to share this with my students, but I wish that it were at different levels to make it more accessible for them. Well, now we got you. I'm really excited to announce and showcase our new text leveler. So where are you going to find it? I'm going to move over to the homepage. So those of y'all who've logged into Newsela, you're going to see that this is the homepage, and you're going to see upon launch this guy right up here. You can go ahead and click level your own text. This is going to take you to the actual text leveler. Okay, so how does this work? As you can see, basically you're just going to be pasting in the article or the text that you found out in the open web, paste it in here. And I actually have a snippet of an article that I found just to kind of show how this works. It is about Romeo and Juliet, but a modern stage adaptation to show that Shakespeare is like still influential to this day. So I'm going to go ahead and paste this in, and you can see that immediately you're going to see the text level of the text that I just pasted in. So this is a 12th grade level text, And here you can go ahead and choose the level that you want to go to. So maybe the seventh grade, or maybe you want to choose multiple. Maybe you want to choose fifth as well. So those are, you just go ahead and choose which grade levels you want to level to. Go ahead and hit generate levels and it'll get started. So as it's going, eventually you're going to pop up and you're going to land on the actual levels, level text. So you can see here that we have the seventh grade, we have the fifth grade. This is the text that Luna generated for us. But if you want to compare it to the original text, you can totally do that. Just hit this toggle right here. You can see the source text as well as the generated text. Now you're looking at this, maybe you're thinking like, hey, that's great, very cool, but I want to add some more stuff to it. Maybe I want to edit it. That is totally fine. So I'm thinking maybe you want to add the title, maybe you want to add the source URL. You can go ahead and hit edit text right here. And I'm just going to paste this in so we can see the source URL. And maybe you want to format this as well. So I'm going to format that. This is looking pretty good. All right, I'm going to go ahead and hit done editing. From here, you can copy it to the clipboard, or you can go ahead and print that. It'll export it as a PDF for you so you can distribute to your students. So really excited about this. We're really excited to get the text leveler as well as all of our other tools that I was mentioning before, like translations, the AI-powered graphic organizers from Luna into your hands for back to school. We have a lot more in the works, so stay tuned. We're just getting started. One more thing I should talk about with us getting started is we're getting started here with Luna. We want to make sure that we're being very deliberate, purposeful, and research-backed. We want to make sure that we are supporting teachers as they are designing these lessons for their students. And so we just think it's really important that the choice lies with the teacher in how they incorporate all this AI stuff into their curriculum.